Hi, and welcome to the first video tutorial by Squawk Ident. Today we will be demonstrating the VOR runway 34 approach into Melbourne Airport using the constant descent approach method. Let's now quickly brief for the approach. We have tuned 114.1 into both nav radios and have orally identified Mike Lima. Our final approach course is 346, and that's what we've selected on both the HSI and the regular CDI just below that. Our final approach fix is at 6.5 DME, and we'll cross that at 1,970 feet, and the MDA is 760 feet. Missed approach procedure is to track 346, climb at 4,000 feet, or as directed by ATC. We're now approaching Tona, which is the 11 DME fix on this radial, and we will begin our descent at 9.7 DME. Our ground speed is about 120 knots, so we'll descend at about 650 feet per minute. When we reach the final approach fix, we'll be getting into our landing configuration and slowing to 100 knots, so we'll need to bring our descent back to about 500 feet per minute. Our MDA is 760 feet, so if we're not visual by about 800 feet, we'll execute the missed approach procedure. Okay, so we're coming up to 9.7 DME now, and just beginning our descent. And we want to cross 9 miles at 2770. Nine miles slightly high, 8 miles at 2450. Miles on slope on speed. 7 miles at 2130. Okay, just correct for that slight wind shear. Okay, there's that gain. So we'll use that. Okay, 7 miles, slightly low. Final approach fix 6.5 at 1970. On slope. We'll just put the gear and flaps out and slow to 100 knots. 6 miles at 1810. Slightly low, 5 miles at 1490. Okay, just add some power to maintain 500 feet per minute. And 100 knots. It's 5 miles and we're about 100 feet low. 4 miles at 1180. So as you can see, we're getting a bit low on profile here. And there's 4 miles, and we're still about 100 feet long. 3 miles at 860. And we should reach our MDA at about 2.7. So there's 3 miles, we're still on slope. Just have a look outside in a moment. And it's still completely white outside. No runway, not visual, so we'll go around. Okay, positive climb. Gear up. Flaps up to approach again. I'm sure we're tracking 346. That's actually the same as our inbound course in the VOR, so we're following the CDI, it'll be a good guide. Okay, as you can see, DME readout now, just about over our missed approach point, and already about 1,000 feet above the aerodrome. So it's got us away nice and safely. So as you can see there, the constant descent approach method allowed us to get down nice and smoothly without having to level off at intermediate steps. Of course, this allows us to shoot much more efficient and safer approaches, especially in high-performance aircraft, where leveling off requires a significant amount of power. Thank you for watching, and if you're interested in seeing more tutorials and resources like this video, feel free to visit our website at squawkident.org.